Please, please state your name for the folks at home, would you?
Frida.
Marielle.
Nicole.
Christine.
You're welcome. Ladies, where are you from?
Norway.
Norway!
Norway!
Yay. Hang on a second.
Yes, I keep the flags of many nations in my jacket. What are you doing in America?
Having a good time.
Come here. Don't try too hard. It kind of looks needy. Do you know what I mean? Bring it down. That's what I do every night, and it looks kind of weird. It gives people a creepy vibe. You know what I'm saying? So, girls, you're having a good time in America, are you? Yeah. Do you know the Norwegian band A-ha?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
This is your last
fart line.
So, you know A-ha, do you? They're from Trondheim in Norway, aren't they? No. Yes, yes, they are.
No?
No? We're from Trondheim, though.
You're from Trondheim?
Yeah.
No, A-ha are from Trondheim. They really are.
No.
Are you guys going to do some kind of Norwegian kick-ass ninja glug? Because I'm in. So what are you doing here? You're just on vacation?
Yeah.
And you all live in this, you travel around together and solve mysteries? Because I think that would work on the CW. Yep. I think if you guys went around in a car and solved mysteries while wearing great shoes, kids would love that. Are you interested in Hollywood as a destination for a career, perhaps?
No.
Then my powers are useless. Then what do you do? Are you studying?
No,
just traveling.
Just traveling.
But you're like traveling people?
Yeah.
What do you do in Norway? What do you study? Or are you study or work or?
We have a free air.
You have free air? Oh, you have a free year. Like a gap year.
Yeah.
Before university. What are you going to study at university?
I'm going to study business.
Business, yes.
I'm going to be a nurse.
A nurse. Of course you are. Yes.
I don't know.
You don't know?
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. And?
I don't know either.
Right. Well, I just think I reached maximum creepy this evening, everyone. I hope you guys have a great time. And we've got a prize for you, I've just decided. What have you got? Candy? I'm not giving candy to young girls. Come on. No, I'm not giving them any puppets either. I'm not giving them toys or candy. You're going to have to think of something else. Dinner? Dinner! Yeah, dinner. I'm not going, though. You send them to dinner. Where are you going to send them?
What's your favorite place?
I like Wolfgang Puck's place. Right, we're going to send you to Wolfgang Puck's restaurant. He's going to pay.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Progressive. Visit progressive.com today. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
everyone. Thank you. That was lovely. Very, very believable indeed. Everybody sit down. And you made me do finger pistols. Finger pistols is the name I once made a movie under. Craig, were you in a porn? In a porn? Well, I participated. Man, it got creepy right out of the gate tonight, didn't it? What do you think, Jeff?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I've been working on an impression of you. You ready?
Yeah.
Girl. What do you think?
Couldn't understand a word.
Yeah. Girl. You know what? I should be you for a night, and you be me for a night.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Girl.
It's a great day for America, everybody.
It is, in fact, a great day for America, everybody. No, I tell you, it actually is because America has a new power couple. Apparently, this is me trying to drum up enthusiasm for something I don't give a rat's ass about, but apparently, ooh, wait till you hear this, Jeff. Kanye West is dating Kim Kardashian. Move over, Brangelina. They're going to have a combined name. Kanye-dashian? Kimye. Kimye. Kimye's not bad, is
That's
it?
That's good. That's mm-hmm. good.
You got any?
Yeah, bad idea.
Okay. Kanye says he's written a song about Kim. It'd be pretty easy to write a song about Kim Kardashian. All you need is a bunch of words that rhyme with hairy. But... oh, that's right. Me, you bastards. Do you know what I think's funny? Do you know what happened there? I saw a bunch of girls who went, ooh. I always get Kim Kardashian mixed up with Snooki. That's how I remember him, is it? Kim Kardashian's the hairy one and Snooki's smooth. Apparently, Snooki said that she's getting blonde hair extensions. I'm like, I don't think that's a good idea. I don't think Snooki should go blonde. People will think she's dumb. See what I did? Do you see what I did? Turn it around!
Oh, man.
All right. Now, It looks like the race for the Republican nomination is going to be ending. Rick Santorum, that you know, the gay guy, he dropped out. He's not? I don't know. I don't follow politics that closely. Do you have a picture of him? You must have that picture of him. You had it last night. Yeah, there he is. Musical theater. Did you just go through your nose there?
Yes, I did. That one was very funny.
Yeah. Well, Rick Santorum's dropped out, so the big story of today is there used to be bird-like dinosaurs. That's true. Look at the headline. You got the headline. Yes, look, bird-like dinosaur fossil found with eggs. There. It's adorable. Give me a close-up of that picture. What the hell is that? Larry King! For heaven's sake. Yes. That's right, Larry King is 70 million years old.
Hey, any of you dinosaurs want to be my fifth wife?
No, this is actually a big discovery. It's a big deal because the fossils of dinosaurs and their eggs have never been found in the same place. For one, I think it's nice that scientists found eggs on Easter week. I think it's lovely. I hope we find eggs. We did! If I were one of the scientists who I had played a trick on the other scientists, I would have secretly switched the dinosaur eggs with Cadbury's cream eggs. Good heavens, these baby dinosaurs are delicious, aren't they? Chocolate covered with white gooey substance. Reminds me of my days in the Navy.
Too far, man.
Really?
No, not at all.
Anyway, look, the dinosaurs, they weren't just ordinary dinosaurs. They were called alvirosaurids. I know. Well, basically, it means big, nasty birds. And instead of wings, they had tiny little arms. And each arm had one big, sharp claw on it, which tells you one thing, they were not masturbating very often. That's That's why they're angry. They were like, That's because masturbation cheers you up. That's why I'm so perky. They did get tiny little arms. You know, and you know who else has tiny little arms? Mick Jagger. That's why he can't get no satisfaction. Yeah. Man, we really got nothing tonight, but we're selling.
Top shelf, man.
Top shelf. All right, now the dinosaurs, these dinosaurs, they could rip your stomach open with their giant claws that were on their tiny little arms, and then they would use their huge beaks to play records. From the Flintstones, you know, in the Flintstones, from the thing?
Yeah, I got it.
Anyway, I think everybody knows that modern-day birds are descended from dinosaurs, but I don't understand how that happened. I think what happened is there were some interspecies getting it on. Because, you know, the dinosaurs had sex with pigeons. Because they... Yes, they did, because it was easier than masturbating. They're like... And everyone knows that pigeons are whores. So the dinosaurs would be like, and the pigeons would be like... Hey, that's how much material we got tonight. I just did, you know, a dinosaur and a pigeon getting it on. I don't think I get much more on dinosaurs. Oh, wait, no, dinosaurs, they would run in herds and make uniform direction changes, like a bird of birds avoiding a predator. I learned that from Jurassic Park. That thing. No, I also learned from Jurassic Park that there was that really weird creature, that really weird-looking creature. What was it called? Give me a picture of that thing. Yeah, that's it. Now, you know Jeff Goldblum, if he were in a position where he had to, he would have sex with a pigeon.
Oh, yeah, no question.
In fact, even if he didn't have to, even if someone said, hey, Jeff, you want to have sex with a pigeon? He'd be like, mm-hmm. And the pigeon would be like... What do you think?
This is comedy gold, man.
Comedy gold, man. I'm telling you, this is another Peabody in the making tonight. This one.
We are making history.
You're making history. It's a shame it's not comedy, but at least it's history.
What are you staring at, lesbians?
Hey! Don't be hating on the lesbians. What the hell, man?
I'm not hating, man. I'm not hating.
What do you mean? You said, what are you staring at? That's slightly aggressive.
Just keeping them on their toes.
Do the thing.
Yeah. Tonight's program is brought to you by a steamy new thriller. She was a pigeon of the night. He was the man who ruffled her feathers. Craig Ferguson, 9.5 beaks.
Everybody, you ready, Jeff?
Yeah.
Dude, is that a cat noise you make, or is it actually a cat in there?
It's whatever you want it to be.
That doesn't even make sense. What you do is you just say things that don't make sense, but you do it in a creepy, weird voice so that people laugh. Kind of what I do.
Whatever helps you sleep at night.
Nah. What was that impression I did of you again? What did I do?
Oh, yeah. It's getting there.
Yeah, all right. What time is it, Jeffrey Peter?
It's treat mail time. Time for our viewers to take serious advice from a man whose idea of a feather duster is a pigeon strapped to his junk.
Ha ha ha!
How did you know I do that? Anyway, the pigeon likes it. Now, let's sing our own email jingle. I'm enjoying this, and we've been doing it all this week, and I'm loving it. So let's keep doing it. All right, you ready?
Yeah, okay.
All right, then.
Yeah.
Tweets and emails all the way from Norway. All the way from Norway. Take on my tweets and emails. This is from Adam in Oakland in California. You ever been to Oakland?
Oh, yeah, I got a place.
Got a little place there? Yeah, what do you like to do up there in Oakland? Swimming, naked, nude, beads.
Take a pigeon, dust my...
Pigeons? Foot. Pigeons?
Pigeon in my pants.
Dear Craig and Jeff, how much do you think it is okay to spend on a haircut? Well, clearly about a dollar. Jeff, do you ever get your haircut?
How dare you?
How dare you?
How dare you, sir?
How dare you, sir? How dare you use your Downton Abbey voice on me?
The very idea that you would mock me because I lack follicles.
You lack follicles, sir, because you lack a scalp. You lack a scalp because you lack skin. You lack skin for you are decomposed.
What I lack on my head, I make up for in my pants.
So, you're saying you have a scalp in your pants?
No, I'm saying I have a cat in my pants.
May I hear it? I was confused too, don't worry. This is from Jason in Chicago, Illinois. He says, Dear Craig and Jeff, I'm a Cubs fan. I'm terribly sorry. How do I keep from crying between the months of April and October? Well, yeah, it's gonna be all right. This is from Penelope in New York. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah, love New York.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you like the Big Apple? Or just New York?
Oh, man.
Hi, Craig and Jeff. My boyfriend is a chain smoker and it makes me sick. How'd you get someone else to quit? Jeff, how did you quit smoking?
I found that pigeons were an effective substitute.
There you are, then. Why don't you try and get your boyfriend to enjoy the feathery delights of our pigeon friends? I look forward to your angry, confused letters, particularly from pigeons. That's a pigeon typing, what do you think?
You're awesome, man.
Move right back, everybody. Show, the CBS wholesome alternative to the late night profanity of other shows, right, Jeff? My first guest, I don't know why that's funny. It's funny to me, and that's half the battle. My first guest tonight is on a new CBS show, poor bastard. It's called NYC 22, which premieres this Sunday at 10 p.m. Please welcome the adorable, handsome, and smells like biscuits, Adam Goldberg, everybody. Adam Goldberg.
Thank you.
The hell, man, I hardly recognize you.
Yeah, I know, I'm working.
Yeah, I could see that. Like,
I'm here to promote a television
yeah,
program.
Yeah, I can see. Usually you turn up here, but once a month, you're all raggedy and wearing jeans and going, hey, I heard a podcast that was awesome. Look at you, your hair's combed.
Wow.
You're wearing slacks. Is that slacks
well,
you're wearing?
Well, let me be clear about something. These are Wrangler pants. They're about $35.
Okay.
This, however, Paul Smith. Whoa. So now the show has to get picked up because I'm in deep trouble. otherwise.
You went ahead and bought the jacket before you know the show is going to be a hit.
Yeah, basically that's the
sort of thing I do. You really combed your hair as well.
I really brushed. I actually brought a brush to the show. It's in my dressing room along with Steve Jones's shirt, which was in there for some reason.
Steve Jones was here earlier in the week.
Yeah, it's okay. It's all right. We can share a dressing room. listen, I know we have a whole thing and we're here for business and we got to, you know.
Who,
all right. the royal we.
Right.
But can I ask the girls, the blondes, something?
No, I don't. I have some information that you may not want to talk to the girls.
Really?
Mm.
Why is that?
Oh, you know.
Oh, that's not what I'm referring to. I just wanted to know if they happened to be in an ice cream section at a supermarket in Los Feliz on, I think it was like 2 days ago. Did you guys go ice cream shopping the other day? With very, like, Scandinavian accents, you know, so far as I can tell.
You are a creepy man.
Yeah, I know.
He's got a picture of blonde girls buying ice cream.
Well, I want to contextualize this first.
Right.
All right, I am a creepy man.
Yeah.
But I just want to contextualize.
Do you have Angry Birds on this? Because I could play it while you're talking.
Yeah. I'm in airplane mode, so I don't know what happens.
Right,
I didn't want to get any call, you know.
Yeah.
But what happened is that there were these sort of Scandinavian women.
Yeah, I know. There's some over there. Right.
Very blonde. Mm-hmm. You have to consider yourself fairly blonde, right?
Mm-hmm.
Tan, healthy. You know, this is all very foreign to me. And and they're in that particular. I don't think I can say the name of the ice cream, but it's something that's got a sort of Scandinavian.
Häagen-Dazs.
There you go.
Got it.
There's lots of umlauts in the name, and they were there for...
Are you allowed to say that?
I think you'd say umlaut. Can you say umlaut on TV?
I know what an umlaut is.
Can you say...
It's like a clitoris.
Right.
It's a mythical creature.
It's the clitoris of grammar.
Right.
So anyway, they were there for like an eternity, and it was just incredibly ironic. So yeah, I had to sort of perv them with my phone. But it's not.
It wasn't you guys. I could tell. I think LA is overrun by hordes of.
Hordes?
Great herds.
Herds.
Herds of Scandinavian women all over LA, all enjoying ice cream.
I didn't know that until the other day. I mean, I'm thrilled.
It's nice. You better tell me about the show. It's on CBS. Gosh diggity.
Yes, it's on CBS. I feel like Patty Hearst.
Nah, you're all right, man. It's all right. Yeah.
What do you want to know about the show? Oh, I've never been able to plug anything. I don't know how it works.
Tell me how awesome it is.
It's a great new cop show on Sunday night on CBS.
Do you play a cop?
Yes, I play a rookie officer.
Really?
Older. Yeah, I play an ex, like, journalist, a crime writer who gets fired from his job from a newspaper because they don't make those anymore.
And co-op things are so bad in the NYPD that they're taking guys fired from newspapers?
Exactly, who are, like, a little long in the tooth. And I'm, like, kind of a drunk, and I'm kind of, you know, I'm kind of messed up.
Are we still talking about the show here, or just...
We're talking about typecasting.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah.
A little bit.
No. You know I'm not a drunk. I'm a pill popper.
That is true.
I'm a junkie. Let's be clear about that.
Well, that's why you've kept your figure. Yeah.
That is.
Yes, scares.
Actually, it was funny that you were talking about that, talking about bird dinosaurs and that kind of
thing. Oh, yeah. The audience loved that. When I was talking about the bird dinosaurs, they were like, more of that, please. We came all the way from Scandinavia for this.
I got more, man. I got a call back for that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I was on a paleo diet for about 3 days last week. You know what that is?
Paleo diet?
It's like when you just eat meat and kind of like no grains, and it's incredibly strict, and you can't have any kind of like nuts, and it's awful,
basically. How awful that must be. You can't have any nuts. What the hell?
No, you can't. You can't.
I'd probably go for weeks without having nuts.
No, but you can't.
And I'm not on a diet.
You can't have rice or anything like that.
Can't have rice or nuts.
Pasta.
How do you get by?
Pasta.
All right, pasta.
All right. So no, it's like you're eating like ox and moose and things like that.
Oh, really?
Well, I didn't. I had like nice like lean chicken or whatever. But the point is that I tried to be this very healthy thing or this thing that's supposed to like. You know, give you an extra 6 months or whatever.
Right.
Because I'm just trying, wherever I can get it. I was trying to floss to get an extra 6 months, mm-hmm. So I've been flossing every day. So now I'm up to whatever, you know, 74.
What if you floss with meat?
If you floss with meat, you live to be about 97.
Yeah. But is it worth it?
No, because by the time you're in, 80, 85, I would.
No, Matt, you're in CBS. You're hitting the demographic right between the eyes right now.
Right. By the time you're 85, you're enjoying.
In your prime.
NYC.
In your prime.
You're enjoying. What camera am I on? By the time you're 85, you're enjoying NYC 2-2 Sunday night, 10 p.m.
We'll be right back after some more messages like this.
So, yeah, you decided... welcome back, everybody. You decided to go with the no beard on this show, then.
I didn't have a choice. I was a rookie cop. I mean, I tried, but they wouldn't... I think I worked a stash into the second year if it gets picked up.
Right.
Because that's as hairless as I've been in many, many years. I can't even look...
Magnum couldn't solve crimes?
No, I know. Yeah, but it's when you're a beat cop, apparently, you can't have... You can have a stash, but it has to go to right here. It can't go lower than here.
All right.
And I think that, you know, for the first year, they want to have me on and whatever, but really it's just hideous. I can't look at that clip. I mean, the hair is too short.
Stop selling this show.
The hair is too short. The hair is too short.
You look
makes my head look even smaller.
Your head is the average size.
I think I have a small oblong head.
No, you got an average size head. A lot of people talk about that. When they say, I saw you at Goldberg.
Right.
Average head. You're famous for it.
I get that a lot.
People...
You're the guy. Wait a minute. Average head.
Oh, I remember seeing Private Ryan. You were the guy with the average head.
Totally average.
Well, we're out of time.
Look, the girls are laughing. They were really giving me a dirty look when I was being a tad, I suppose, lascivious.
Well, now they've seen you without a beard, they've realized there's possibilities.
Right. Wow. anyway, so how you been?
I'm good, man. I just said we were out of time, but you ignored me.
Oh, really? I was just kind of getting, I was really getting into my groove. I was starting to get a little comfortable. You know,
I noticed that, and that's why I said.
No. Adam, everybody, Adam Goldberg, everybody will be right back with Robbie Montgomery.
You know, you might want to stop putting that on the camera. I don't read it, and it just annoys the guests.
Yeah. Don't put that on the camera.
Well,
it's annoying, man. It's offensive to the guests.
It's offensive to the guests.
It pisses Craig off.
Yeah, it pisses me off.
You know, the audience is uncomfortable.
Well, to be fair, they were uncomfortable on the way in.
I only got $1.50 from last time. I was looking forward to this.
The big cash prize?
Yeah, I've spent...
What time is it, Shadow Stevens?
It's time for the big cash prize.
All right.
Points?
Points, yeah. $50 in quarters in a bag with a dollar sign on it.
I gotta tell you.
Yeah.
As an Angelino, very convenient.
Very convenient. Right. Put it in the cup holder. Right. You'll never get a parking ticket
That's
again.
Right. All right, I like
it. Okay, you ready?
All right, hold on.
All right, there's two ways to win.
Yeah.
You can either answer a question.
Right.
Which I have over here.
Is it a trivia question?
Hold on. There's another way. Or it could be trivia, it could be history, it could be science, it could be sexual.
Can it be about me? I'm not good with
it. Yeah, it might be about you.
Okay.
Actually, this first one is. Or you can guess what's in my box. Here's how that works. I imagine a box in my head. I don't know what's in it. Only Jeff knows what's in it. You guess what's in it. If you're right, Jeff will tell us. And if you're wrong, something really bad happens to you.
What would you guys prefer, Jeff? Was that gas?
Yeah, he's got terrible gas.
He has
that gas that gets so bad it sounds
comes
like
out of his mouth.
Sounds like a cat.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Yeah, you ever had that?
As a matter of fact.
All right, so I'll give you a question then.
Okay, all right.
Iceland is in the North Atlantic.
Oh,
it's
God, I can't,
city.
I can't.
Wait,
Let me guess what's in the box. What's in the box?
All right.
Reykjavik.
Wait. I'm imagining a box in my head. I don't know what's in it. Jeff knows what's in it.
Okay.
Adam, what's in my box?
I got it. A lesbian paleontologist.
Jeff?
We would have also accepted a T-Rex umlaut. But that is the correct answer.
Welcome back. back. As you can probably tell by my change in outfit, we're doing a political interview now, something a little... No, my next guest stars in Welcome to Sweetie Pies, which is on Saturday nights on OWN. Please welcome the extremely talented Robbie Montgomery, everybody. Robbie.
Thank you. Thank you. All right.
That's Oprah. Oprah owns that network.
Oprah does. She does. Have you ever, First time I heard it pronounced like that, but that's great.
Oprah?
Oprah.
Well, how do you pronounce it then?
Oprah.
I just said Oprah.
I know you did. I just repeated.
Oprah.
Oprah. Oprah.
Are you from Norway by any chance? All right, what are we having then?
Okay, we're going to do our honey hot spicy chicken.
Yeah.
So first, I'm going to have you help me.
Yes, okay.
We're going to take this hot sauce, pour it in that pot.
All right, then. How much do you need?
All right, all of it.
Wow, really?
We don't mess around.
Yeah,
we'll do it all.
We may have to go to hospital.
That's all right.
All right.
I've got the other
one. You're glad you came now, eh, Norwegians?
That's right.
Right.
We're going to dump all the sugar in there.
All the sugar?
All this sugar. We like sweet.
All right.
Sweet. But let's put this butter in there.
Yeah, all this butter?
All this butter.
All right.
We're going to do it all.
All right, then.
We're going to put a little honey in there.
Yeah, how much honey do you want? All honey?
Honey, that's enough. Yeah. Okay, that's good.
You said that before.
All right.
Yeah.
That's right. Were you there? Did I say it to you?
Yeah, you would never say it to me.
I would.
No, you wouldn't. Right. No, you wouldn't. You'd
I
be
wouldn't
like,
stop you.
Let's keep going. That's what you'd be saying.
I can tell.
All right.
Okay, now we're going to squeeze that lemon in there.
That's all the lemon?
That's all.
Get?
That's all.
Well, because it's fruit. You don't want to get over healthy
that's
with it.
Right.
Right.
Okay, we're going to stir that up.
Why?
Because we want to. I'm going to make sure it's together.
All right. I think it's.
Okay, we're going to let that happen. Oh, he's a mess. Ah! Yuck.
It's all right. He does the cleaning up. That's the real way out.
Where's your restaurant?
Well,
we want to make sure we don't come to your restaurant.
What?
Okay, that's good right there. We're going to do next. We're going to move on to our. Good for you. That's what you get. That's what you get.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You forgot the name. Honey Hot. Honey Hot. Okay.
I feel like I'm 20 years old.
All right. Gave you a little inspiration.
Wow.
Okay. Now we're going to move on. I'm going to have you.
Is this legal?
That's legal. You don't have to have a license for that. I'm going to have you help me cut up the onions.
I'll cut up the onions.
Okay. Don't cut your hand.
Okay.
Don't cut your hand. That's good. We're going to put them in this pot. We're going to give you a green pepper.
All right.
That's good.
You got to cut them up with it.
Cut it up, yeah.
All right,
just
ready?
Cut it up. Oh, Lord. Okay, that's good. I'm going to take this knife.
Potato?
Not yet.
More hot sauce.
Not yet.
All right.
Okay, we're going to put all that in there.
Put it in there.
That's right. Seeds and all. That's it.
All right.
Okay, what about this red pepper?
Let's cut it up. Cut it up the red pepper.
That's good. Good.
All right.
Let's add it in there.
Right.
Okay, now we're gonna add our corn.
All right, corn.
Put that in there.
All right, corn goes in there.
We're gonna do this sugar.
Sugar goes in there. More sugar
put
in
this
it.
Butter.
Yeah, butter. Yeah.
All right.
I'm sensing a pattern. It's all these things, isn't it? All right.
Little garlic.
Garlic.
All right, stir it up. Same.
Stir it up. All right.
That's good. All right. That is great. Okay, good enough.
Right.
I gotta stop this guy. He gets out of hand.
Yeah.
We're gonna go over here to our green beans.
Yeah.
Now, that's it. I don't want you to gain weight on the show. We're going to hold it. We're going to dump we got our chicken broth. We got our butter. Let's put it in there.
All right, put it in there.
Okay,
yeah.
We're going to dump this butter in there.
Right, okay.
We're going to put these potatoes in there.
What are we doing here? I thought we were making this for that.
What are we going on?
I was
going to have you cut the potatoes, but you're too fast.
All right,
okay, so we're going to do that. When this is boiling for 5 minutes, we're going to dump these green beans in here. Would you help me?
Yeah, all right.
Okay.
Yeah,
thank
green
you.
Beans, yeah.
I'm going to hold this pot because I don't want you to get burned.
No, I don't want to get burned
either.
I don't think it's possible to get burned after.
Come on. You stir that for me.
Okay. All right.
Stir that up for
That's
me.
That's fantastic.
Okay.
All right.
Now we're going to take our pigeon.
Yeah.
The pigeon.
Is
He's eating the pigeon before we dump it in the sauce.
Oh, that's what it's
that's
for.
That's what it's for. The pigeon is for the dump in
it's
the
It's not
sauce.
Really pigeon, is it?
Well, I thought you heard you use pigeon earlier.
I don't.
I would go there.
It's a little bit.
So I go there.
All right.
All right.
So dip it in here?
Dip it in there.
All right.
That's perfect, perfect.
And then just eat it?
And then you got, no, we got a finished plate for you over here.
All right.
We're going to use this. And you could also give Jeff some. Hi, Jeff.
Yeah, hey.
Hi.
He's on the paleo diet or something.
We got to get a little piece of this. We got some plates.
Is this the one that's prepared earlier?
This is prepared.
Oh, I love that. Don't you love cooking on TV? It's just right. Like, you do all this, and then it turns out like this.
That's right. Thank God
yeah.
for that, because look at that peppers, the size you put them. And this is the finished product. Right here, let me get you something to wipe your hands God. With.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay. That's okay, little baby.
This is great.
I'm glad.
Oh, no, glad. This is better than Norway.
Oh. I am so glad.
No, it's great.
You're an excellent chef. You see how you're
I'm a pretty bad
out?
Chef, I mean, you know. Are you, I mean, you cook, your sons cook, will you, don't you?
Yes, yeah. My son cooks. My whole family cooks.
Yeah, your son a good chef?
He's pretty good. He thinks he's better than I am. But not really.
No, he can't be. Yeah, nobody's better than us.
That's right.
This is amazing.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That's a good thing.
Yeah, it's a shame it's a talk show because I got nothing.
Okay. So, that is great. I'm glad. This is so great. For once, I've heard you be quiet. I've never heard that. I never heard that before. Don't get it on you. Here's a napkin for you. Now he's turned into a little baby. I got to take care of him. Wipe his mouth. Wipe his mouth. You want me to wipe your...
Yeah. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back.
Was that you or Jeff? Was that your mouth or your other?
No, it wasn't.
Okay.
We don't do that kind of humor on this show.
Good.
Well,
good.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Jeff and Robbie? We learned how to cook chicken.
That's right.
You got dessert?
I got dessert for you.
Oh, yeah.
Got pear cobbler.
Pear cobbler? Yes. Is that like peach cobbler?
Sort of, but it's sort of down the line.
Down
Not
the
his
line?
Sister, his nephew.
All right.
So, we're going to do this.
I was trying to lose weight. I was on that paleo diet.
I'm just going to give you a little bit so you can taste it. This is one of my mom's desserts.
Oh, yeah?
Here. A lot of people never heard of it.
What, pear cobbler? Because I never heard of pear cobbler.
I know.
How do you... I don't care how you make it.
Okay. What do you think? I like to put a little whipped cream on it, but I didn't want you to...
I don't know if you should, because... It's sensational.
Good. Thank you.
I mean, it really is sensational. Now, where do you have a restaurant?
I have a restaurant in St. Louis.
St. Louis? I've been there.
St. Louis, you have?
Yeah.
Why do you come to my restaurant?
Well, I didn't know it was there. Where is it?
In St. Louis.
I know it's in St. Louis, but what's the name of the restaurant?
Sweetie Pies.
Oh,
Sweetie
Pies. That's the name of the show.
The show,
yeah.
Exactly.
I forgot you were on to plug something. I was just eating the food.
All right.
Why is it called Sweetie Pies?
Because, I mean, all of our recipes got sugar in it.
Yeah, they do.
I was trying to think of something that people call each other. Like, I call you, hi, Sweetie Pie.
Yeah. Yeah, if Jeff had a restaurant, it'd be called Bitch.
Jeff, I love you, Bitch. I love you.
I love you. I love you, baby.
All right, baby.
Hey,
okay,
hey.
That's all right.
Hey.
I've been called worse names. Bitch is appropriate.
Is it?
I'm one today.
No. Okay. Anyone that can do this is an angel.
Okay, I'll take that. Thank you so much.
Well, of course I'm going to talk like that. Look how much is left. Good night, everybody. Good night. Bye.